Okay, so we've been walking for about a half an hour now, mostly uphill, although a nice slow rise. And we're almost at the top. You can see there's the top. Here's where we are. And really hard to see, but way off in the distance is where we came from. You can see the way the trail goes around and then loops again. And it's just around and around and up and down. And at this point, it's all up. So it's not bad to take a few minute break here. Fairly open still, and you'll see in a little while why they call it the Black Forest. But we're in an open area pretty well here. It's about 2 degrees this morning, so a bit nippy, but a lovely day for a walk. So we'll talk to you again fairly soon. Okay, so now you can see we're starting to get into a little bit different trees. We'll go back to where we came from, and you can look at the kinds of trees. We're going to have to tell you what they are because I can't remember. But fairly open to the sky. And now we're getting into typically what I think of as the Black Forest. So you see the different trees, and suddenly it's still daylight. But look how dark it's getting as we come in here. The light's now coming on the camera so that you can see where we're going. But look up, fairly dense canopy, so it stays fairly dark in here. And as I said, the lights come on the camera so that we can actually see where we're going. And so you can see what you're doing. Clarence! And here comes a boy. Come on, bud. Okay. So we'll walk up here a bit. And you can see they have the paths fairly well marked with a whole bunch of different signs that I don't necessarily know what they mean, but I know I'm on the right track. So here we go. This is the part where you get to exercise. You just step in place and walk along with us, and you're going on a hike through the Black Forest. Now, I'm sure the camera shake is making you nauseous, so I'm going to turn this off, pause it, and I'll be back in a little while. Boy. As you can tell, this is not your typical easy walk in the park. We're still going uphill. Although we are getting closer to the top. And once you actually get to the top, you don't necessarily know it because the canopy is so dense. You actually can't see anything from up there. Just look how beautiful this is. There's up the hill. There's way down the hill. Hopefully soon we'll get to a lookout point where you can actually see how high up we are. Okay, so here's something I found really funny along the trail. We're about 45 minutes into the walk, and we come upon this. The exercises you should do. Seems to me this should be at the beginning of the trail and not in the middle, although I suppose if you're starting to cramp up halfway through, you should think about doing these. But I just think that's the funniest thing ever, to be in the middle of a trail. And here we are. I'm just going to back up a bit because we're at a crossroads in the trail. And there, I'll just go backwards instead of walking backwards because I don't want to trip. We came from over there where the dog is, and we had a choice here. And the choice is go down that way where the sign is, or up that way. And you'll notice there's a little sign, wooden sign leaning against a tree up there, and it's pointing to a different trail. So this is, the lower one is the trail we want to stay on. this trail goes up just a little bit farther to the very top and then over the crest and down into the next valley, and that's not where we want to go. We want to continue along this trail because we want to stay in the valley that we're in so that we can get to Elzach. Okay, see you soon.